Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I wanted to do a high bun hairstyle. I feel like I don't do high bun hairstyles very often, and I do have a similar tutorial to this one. It's from a few years ago, so I've changed a few things. The bun is definitely different. It's very labor intensive, so if you don't want to take the time to do this bun, you can always switch it out for your favorite type of bun. Either way, I hope you learned something from today's video. Make sure to like and subscribe and click that notification bell so you never miss future tutorials, and let's get started. To start this hairstyle, I'm going to start by parting my hair on the right side. I want a deep side part just for the braid. And then I'm going to divide out the section of hair that I want to use for my braid. And then with the remaining hair, I'm just going to put this up into a messy bun where I want my braid to sit. Mapping out the hairstyle beforehand will just make sure that everything kind of lays the way that you want it to at the very end. So now I'm going to start my braid, and I'm going to divide out a small section of hair near the part line and then split this into three smaller pieces. I'm going to start like a regular French braid, so I'm just crossing the side strands over the middle strand, and I am going to bring in one piece on the back side of the braid just to help anchor the braid against the head. This is the only piece I'm bringing in on this side. And then I'm going to cross the left strand over the middle and bring in a new section. And you'll notice that on this side of the braid, my sections are fairly large. And that's just because I want some volume along the front side of the braid. So I'm just going to continue crossing the side strands over the middle strand, bringing in sections of hair along the hairline without adding in any additional pieces on the back side of the braid. Once I've brought in all of the hair that I left out for my braid, then I'm just going to continue braiding the section down to the ends. So again, I'm just crossing the side strands over the middle strand, and I'm not bringing in any additional hair since I tied it up in the messy bun. And then, so the braid doesn't unravel, I'm just going to slide a couple bobby pins over the bottom. Now that the braid is done, I'm going to brush all of my hair up into a high ponytail, and I'm going to bring the braid in, but I'm just going to add it in last. I want it to sit on top of the hair instead of getting buried underneath. And I'm just going to tie all of the hair together with a normal hair tie, and now I can do the bun portion of the hairstyle. So for my particular bun, I'm basically going to take small sections of hair and loop them back towards the head and then pin them in place with bobby pins. So I'm just starting at the top front of the ponytail, and I'm just dividing off a small to medium sized section. I'm going to brush through it and hairspray it with hairspray. I recommend spraying all of the sections with hairspray. This will just help control frizz. I'm using a medium hold hairspray. This is really good for controlling frizz without making the hair sticky and stiff. So I'm just going to take sections from the ponytail, brush through them, hairspray them, and then loop them towards the head. And I'm sliding in bobby pins on both sides of the sections. You don't have to hook all of the hair into the bobby pin. I just like to get a few pieces of hair and then slip the bobby pin underneath the loop so that it doesn't show. And if you pin both sides of the loop, this will really help the loops stay in place without falling loose as you wear the hairstyle. So I'm just going to start at the top front of the ponytail, and then I'm going to slowly work my way down the right side of the hairstyle. And as you work, kind of gauge how big you want your pieces to be. I kind of have an idea of how many loops I will be able to make because I've done this hairstyle before. If you start out taking too big of sections, then you'll end up with just a tiny bit of hair for the back and bottom side of the bun. So just make sure to take smaller sections, and then you can always create more loops if you need to. So once I've done the right side of the bun and gotten down towards the back, I'm going to start kind of building the bun up. So I'm going to start placing loops on top of the previous loops that I had already pinned. This will just help create some volume and dimension within the bun. I didn't want my bun to be just like a flat donut bun. I wanted it to kind of come up and out. So this will just help achieve that if you're layering loops on top of each other. It does really help to look in two mirrors. That way you can see the style from all the different angles. It can be easy to make this bun a little bit not as symmetrical as you'd like, and it can be hard to go back and fix after you've pinned. So definitely check in a mirror to make sure the bun is staying symmetrical. So I usually like to work in a clockwise pattern, starting at the top and then move to the right and then down to the back and then finish on the left side. And as you go, just make sure to kind of fill in any gaps or holes with sections of hair. And the ends from the loops tend to be really small and thin, so I'll just combine those with a new section of hair and just continue looping and pinning the pieces until all of the hair is pinned up into the bun. So that wraps up today's video. As always, thank you so much for watching. I hope you learned something from today's tutorial. Make sure to let me know what you think down below in the comment section. I always read the comments even though I don't always respond to them. Make sure to click the thumbs up if you want to see more high bun hairstyles, of course, and subscribe and click that notification bell so you never miss future videos. And I will see you on the next one.